Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. I'm talking about dermal fillers and some of the reasons why people look unnatural after getting dermal fillers. Many people don't come in and get these procedures because they're worried they're gonna look unnatural. So you only really see people that look unnatural. People say, I don't wanna look like someone on TV, or I don't wanna look like my friends or people in my friend group, they make fun of them. Remember, you don't see the people that look natural, those that address the full face, the frame of the face, the glow, that use different products. What is it that leads to that look? I think one important thing to talk about before we get into that is, what is natural? When people walk into the clinic, they say, hey, I wanna look natural. The cheapest, best thing they can do is turn around and walk out. That's natural. But the point is they don't like what they're seeing. It could be lines, it could be brown spots, it could be loss of glow, all kinds of things. So what they're saying is they want to look rejuvenated in a natural way. And on a whole nother topic that we talk about is, what's the new natural? Because the new natural, which is the next step, is not fully natural. It's a slightly bigger lip, it's a slightly higher cheek, it's an angle or a fold that maybe someone didn't have before, but it's okay. It just shouldn't be overdone. So let's go into the reasons why people get overdone. Is it that they're choosing it? It just happens. What is it? So number one is that people are addressing the front of the face and not the frame. So instead of pulling back this way, which is a natural look, people want to address the front of the face because it's what they go in and they ask their doctor for. Hey, I want this filled, or they're looking at a line or a fold that isn't gonna make them look younger or rejuvenated. It's what their eye sees in the mirror. So it's most important to listen to your provider after you've given the information. They're gonna make recommendations, and often there's a great reason for recommending what they are about to, because of historically what they've seen with other patients, what they don't want people to look like, and from the trainings that they go to. So don't address the face, start with the frame. The second reason is people go to a provider that may not have all the tools. If someone was coming to build your home and they brought a hammer and nails, you'd turn them away and you'd say, you need someone that can do concrete, with a circular saw, finishing tools, paint. If somebody only has one neuromodulator and a couple fillers, nothing to resurface, maybe no platelet-rich fiber and something we use a lot of, then they can't quite get the result that you could if you have all those tools. So you need the right tools, because 90% of faces that we do are rejuvenations, are multiple treatments. And that's a concept that most people understand now, but it's important to have the tools and ask your practitioner, what are the tools that are necessary? The third one is, we can't possibly have all the tools, so it's important to refer. And I send people away every day for things that I might not have or I'm not able to do, but my colleagues around town or down the street do have or can do, if it's in the best interest of that patient. So making sure that you get the referral you need if you can't obtain what you can from that initial consult. And it is important, we always tell you, get two or three consults before deciding on your treatment. The fourth reason that people look unnatural is, believe it or not, they do what's called double doctoring. So people often get what they want. They might just go to multiple locations until they get it done. And they might see a provider that says, no, I don't think that would look good. They'll find somebody to do it. And it becomes a cycle. So when you see people that look unnatural, it may not be the provider's exact issue, but they're getting stuff done at multiple places to get what they think looks good. And no one's telling them different, or they don't like what people are telling them. So that's a common reason people get too much done in the wrong areas. Number five, trying to save money. This is a classic. When people want to fill one area, because we all have a budget, we can't just all do everything, but you need a master plan, and pick off that plan what makes sense to you and your provider within your budget over time. And it's absolutely important, but if you try and save money in many different ways by taking the special of the day at every different clinic around, chances are, or there's a higher chance at least, that it's not going to look congruent and it's not going to be in harmony, one face part of the face to the other, or the glow versus the skin versus the filling. Try and stick with one provider until proven otherwise. The next is trying to save time. A lot of times people come and they have an event in 2 weeks. We see 1 week, we see 1 day, but 2 weeks is, in our world of minimally invasive medicine, very short. Try and give someone 3 to 6 months to obtain the result that you want. And even in that time frame, there's going to be things that are going to take a little longer. The idea is, in a practice, the patients look more rejuvenated, more refreshed, younger, more youthful over years, not days or weeks. But look at your picture 5 years, 10 years down the road. The idea is that you're looking better than if you hadn't done the procedures, in congruence with what you want to have done and what your end goals are. So if you're trying to save time and have this result within X amount of days, chances are it could look fake. So there's several reasons why people might look fake or overdone or not exactly to your eye how you would want to look. But it's multifactorial typically. It doesn't mean that's the way you need to look. Just have that conversation with your provider, let them know, but also understand you don't want to look totally natural. You want a change. You want to look rejuvenated. You want to look good. And here are the things. But natural, absolutely natural, would be doing nothing. So I hope that helps. Let me know your comments below. What do you see going on out there? Follow us on Instagram. We do a lot of before and after pictures and engage people similar to how we do on YouTube here. And we have a great family of people who subscribe. So click the button below, become one of our family, and join us here to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.